Good morning, it's Mrs. Morlan. Thank you so much for joining me today as we read a book, one of my favorites. It's called A Quiet Place, written by Douglas Wood. Come on, join me on a story. Sometimes a person needs a quiet place. Are you someone who needs a quiet place? I am. I love quiet places. A place to rest your ears from bells ringing and whistles shrieking and grown-ups talking and engines roaring and horns blaring and grown-ups talking and radios playing and grown-ups talking. Well, even grown-ups need a quiet place sometimes, but it can be hard to find one. You have to know where to look. This busy city does not look like it's a quiet place. So this boy here is going to be using his imagination to think of all the quiet places he could go. You could look under a bush. A lilac bush in your own backyard. When you crawl underneath it, all the sounds of the world seem soft and far away. And you could be a pirate finding buried treasure on a desert island. A bush could be your quiet place until someone calls you to clean your room. Ooh, look at this one. You could look in the woods. You might find an old stump for a chair, or a mossy log for a couch, in a green mansion of shadow and sunbeams. It's not really quiet, of course. Blue jays scream warnings and the wind sings in the trees, but it feels quiet. And you could be a timber wolf, the gray ghost of the forest. The woods could be your quiet place, but if the woods are too dark and deep, I don't know, I think I would love the forest. That's one of my favorite places to go. Oh, look at him using his imagination. Wow, he's not in the woods anymore, is he? You could look by the sea, on a beach, in the early morning fog. Your footprints are the first of the day. The waves are roaring and the gulls are crying, but it doesn't seem noisy. And you could be an explorer discovering a lost continent. The beach could be your quiet place, but if the beach is not your cup of tea. That's an idiom. That means it's just not your thing. Where else could you go? Ooh, what does that look like to you? The desert, maybe? Oh yes, you could go to the desert, where the old man cactus reaches for the sky, and far off thunderheads bloom like sky flowers over the mesas. A cactus wren drops by for a visit, while a horned toad blinks in the sun. And you could be a Pony Express rider galloping through the Old West. The desert could be your quiet place, but if the desert is a bit too dry. Oh, I think a lot of kids in my class will like this one because I know what you like to do in your spare time. Fish. You could sit by a pond. A heron by the shore stands still as a tree branch, and the water is so calm it looks like a mirror. Then a frog plops from a lily pad, and your face begins to wiggle. And you could be the world's greatest fisherman, reeling in a monster catch. A pond could be your quiet place, but if the fish aren't biting, the little boy is sitting on a bank And the water is still like glass, and he can see his face kind of wriggle back and forth, especially if that frog plops in, like the story said.
Cool.
Ooh, I wonder how many of you would like this. I don't know. You could look in a cavern where every footstep echoes, and the slow drip, drip of water builds new rocks that hang like icicles or stand like sculptures. So if they come down, rock formations that come down are called stalactites. And if they form up from the bottom, they're called stalagmites. Where days and nights and weeks and years are all the same, you could be a cave dweller in the lair of a saber-toothed tiger. A cave could be your quiet place, but if a cave is too cold and damp, maybe that's not your quiet place. I don't know. You would have to be kind of brave and adventurous. Ooh, look at this one. But of course, you would have to be adventurous to be this guy too, right? You could climb to the top of a mountain where the clouds float by like ships or alligators or elephants. On a hilltop you can see far away and think long thoughts about how and why and what. You could be a mountain climber on top of the world. A hilltop could be your quiet place. But if your legs are too tired for climbing, where could you go next? Let's see. Ooh, look at this one. This one kind of reminds me of the Polar Express a little bit. I like this picture. You could wait for a snowy day. You could lie down in a snowdrift. All around you, the falling snow whispers, the world is wrapped in silence. If you listen closely, you can almost hear it breathing. You breathe softly too, pretending to be a polar bear, sleeping in the land where the snowy silence never ends. A snowdrift could be your quiet place, but if it's too warm for snow, where are they going to go next? Ooh, I like this one. You could visit a museum where brass tigers and bronze lions stand silent guard over fabulous treasures. Every painting is a magic window that your own imagination can open wide and climb through. And you can be an artist admiring a masterpiece that's your own. A museum could be your quiet place, but if the museum is closed for renovation, so if they're closing the museum to fix it up and restore the paintings. Ooh, I like this one. I'm going to show you this picture first. Wow. It's kind of what we're doing now, right? We're reading together. You could go to the secret corner of the library, where the only people talking are between the covers of a book. They speak so softly, you can only hear them in your head. As you read about forests and oceans and deserts and caverns and museums and a thousand other things, a library could be your quiet place, but if the library isn't open, like our library right now is not open, so where else could you go? I like this one. You could come home and clean your room and read your own books and think your own thoughts and feel your own feelings and discover that the very best place of all, the one that's always there, no matter where you go or where you stay. you think his room is really in a jungle? Or do you think he's imagining that or reading about it? So the last part we read was, no matter where you go or where you stay, the best place is the one that's inside of you. I hope you enjoyed this book, A Quiet Place. It's one of my very favorite books because I love learning about and talking about and reading about our imagination and where we can go to escape when things are just too much for us, okay? I hope you're well. I hope you're safe. I miss you. Take care. Bye-bye.